In this example, we have to find out inverse of the given matrix applying row transformation method. So if you are new on my channel, subscribe the channel and hit the bell icon to get the notification of every newly uploaded videos. So we have denoted this matrix by what? A. And whenever we are finding inverse of a matrix, we are using which condition in case of row transformation? That A into A inverse is equal to identity, because we know that A inverse means post factor remains what? Constant in case of row transformation, and our aim is to find out A inverse, so our post factor should be A inverse. Now, to find out value of A inverse, we have to convert this matrix into identity matrix, so that on this side identity into A inverse will become A inverse, and new matrix on this side will be our required value of A inverse. To convert this matrix into identity matrix using row transformation, we have to follow some steps. So our first step is to convert the element of first row, first column into 1, 0, 0. So already 1 is given here. Here we will require 0. So our operation is on R2. 1 minus 1 will become 0. So which operation we have to perform? R2 minus R1. So now, perform the next operation on what? R3. What is the element of R3? 2. 2 minus 2 will become 0. So here our operation is 2R1. Just simply I am multiplying here by 2. So that 2 minus 2 will become what? 0. Perform this operation very carefully on R2 and R3. Since operations are on R2 and R3, so keep element of R1 as it is. Here element of R1 are 1, 2, 3, and on this side 1, 0, 0. Now we are performing which operation? R2 minus R1. 1 minus 1 is 0. 1 minus 2 is minus 1. 5 minus 3 is 2. Now perform this operation on the element of R3. We are using corresponding element of R1, multiply to R1 by minus 2. Multiply by minus 2 to R1. Operation is on R3. Multiply by minus 2, here we will get minus 2, minus 2, plus 2 is 0. Multiply by minus 2. Minus 2 into 2 is minus 4, minus 4 plus 4 is 0. Multiply by minus 2, here we will get minus 6, minus 6 plus 7 is 1. Multiply by minus 2, here we will get minus 2, minus 2 plus 0 is minus 2. Again here, here zeros are there, so here this element does not changes. Perform this operation on this side also on R2. R2 minus R1, 0 minus 1 is minus 1, 1 minus 0 is 1, and 0 minus 0 will be 0. In this way, our first step is completed. Now, what is second step to get this element? 1, 0, 0, 1. This is our second step. Already here we have got minus 1, so we have to convert it into plus 1. But here we have got 0 and 1, 0 and 1. With the help of this one, we are able to convert this element also into 0, and even this element also into 0. This element also into what? 0. Aur yahan pe do zeros hai, isliye ye 1 ka istemal karke, hum ye dono bhi element ko 0 mein convert karenge. Getting it? And this, because zeros are there, so this remaining element does not changes. So first operation is on R1. What is the element of R1? 3. So from 3 we have to subtract 3, that's why I'm multiplying to R3 by 3. So 3R3. The next operation is on R2. What will the operation? So that R2 minus, what is the element of R2? 2. From 2 we have to subtract 2. So to get 2 here, I'm multiplying to R3 by 2. So perform this operation on R1 and R2. So here, keep this A inverse as it is. Perform the operation very carefully on R1 and R3. So our operation is on R3. We are using corresponding element of operation is on R1. We are using corresponding element of R3, and we are multiplying to R3 by minus 3. So here is 0, so here will not change anything. And this operation specially has been 0 to bring here. So directly we are able to write 0 here. On this side, perform this operation very carefully. We are multiplying to R3 by minus 3. Multiply by minus 3, here we will get 6. 6 plus 1 is 7. Again, multiply by minus 3. 0, 0 plus 0 is 0. Multiply by minus 3. Minus 3 plus 0 will be minus 3. Isn't it? Now perform next operation on R2. We are here also, we are using corresponding element of R3, and we are multiplying to R3 by minus 2. Chalo, R3 ko minus 2 se multiply karo. Yaha pe 0 hai, iska matlab ye element change nahi honge. Aur yaha pe specially 0 lane ke liye ye operation kiya hai. So, but on that side, we have to perform this operation very carefully. So, multiply to R3 by minus 2. Multiply by minus 2, here we will get 4. 4 minus 1 is 3. Multiply by minus 2, 0, 0 plus 1 is 1, multiply by minus 2, we'll get minus 2 plus 0 is minus 2. On both sides, keep the element of R3 as it is because there is no operation on R3. Lastly, we will try to convert this element into plus 1. So we are multiplying to R2 by what? Minus 1. Parallelly, I am trying to convert this element also into 0. So our operation is on R1. और 2 में 2 में से 2 सब्ट्रैक्ट करना पड़ेगा, इसलिए यहाँ पे हम R2 को 2 से अगर मल्टीप्लाई करते हैं तो यहाँ पे माइनस 2 मिलेगा हमें, एंड प्लस 2 माइनस 2 मीन्स इफ यू आर टेकिंग एडिशन दिस एलिमेंट विल बिकम व्हाट, 0. सो परफॉर्म दिस ऑपरेशन ऑन R1 एंड सेकेंड ऑपरेशन ऑन व्हाट, R2. ओके वेल, so after this operation this element will become 0, so here we'll get 0 1 1 0 0. After this operation, here we will get plus 1. So 0, 1, 0 and 0, 0, 1 means in short we can say that first matrix will become identity, but perform this operation very carefully on this side. So first operation is on R1, we are using corresponding element of R2 and we are multiplying to R2 by plus 2. So multiply by plus 2, so here we will get 6, 6 plus 7 will be equal to 13, multiply by 2, so 2 plus 0 will be 2, multiply by 2, here we will get minus 4. Minus 4 minus 3 will become minus 7. Now multiply to the element of R2 by minus 1. Multiply by minus 1, minus 3, minus 1, plus 2. Just simply sign will get changed as we are multiplying by minus 1 to the element of R2. Keep element of R3 as it is. So on this side, identity into A inverse will be equal to A inverse, and new matrices on this side will be the required value of A inverse, that is 13, 2, minus 7, minus 3, minus 1, 2, minus 2, 0, 1. In this way, we have got inverse of a matrix applying row transformation method. Now see the example number 19th. Observe the conditions, given conditions very carefully. So in this case, we have to show that with the usual notation for any matrix A, element of this matrix are denoted by Aij and its order is 3 by 3, means 3 rows and 3 columns are there, means 3 into 3, 9 elements are there in this matrix, and every element is denoted by what, small a. So here let us consider the matrix A whose all elements we are denoting by what, small a. It is a order of 3 by 3, means 3 rows and 3 columns are there, and in suffix ij means ij represents what, row and column in which that element appears. So this element appears in first row and first column, here first row, second column, first row, third column, second row, first column, second row, second column, second row, third column, third row, first column, third row, second column, third row, third column. In this way, we have got matrix A. Its every element is denoted by what, A, and it is a matrix of order 3 by 3, and ij represents what, row and column in which that element appears. Now for this matrices, we have to prove these two conditions. So first we are considering the condition first. In the first condition, we have to show that value of A11 into A21 plus A21 into A22 plus A13 into A23 will be equal to 0. I think here A11, A12 is there. Let us check it very carefully because these are the element of what, first row. Yes, here A12 is there. Now let us simplify this expression and try to show that its value is equal to what, 0. And later on we will discuss that how this such type of expression can be used in case of objective type questions also. Okay, so let us simplify it. So here A11, keep it as it is. So this is nothing but what, cofactor. A21 is nothing but what, cofactor. And value of cofactor is what, minus 1 raised to power 2 plus 1 into M21, because minus 1 raised to power I plus j into Mij is the formula to find out cofactor. So this plus A12, keep it as it is. Again, this is capital A represent what, cofactor, and the formula to find out cofactor is minus 1 raised to power I plus j, I is 2, j is also 2, into M22. Lastly, plus A13 into A23, means again it is a cofactor, its value is minus 1 raised to power 2 plus 3 into M23. So which is equal to, so here power of minus 1 is odd number, so its value will be equal to what? Minus 1. And minor means what? It determinant. And to obtain the element of this determinant, delete the element of second row and first column. Delete the element of second row and first column. Write down remaining four elements. So what we'll get here? A12, A13. So we are deleting the element of what? Second row, first column. Second row and first column. So remaining element are A12, A13, A32 and A33. So plus, keep this A12 as it is. Here power of minus 1 is even number, so its value is plus 1. So here write down plus 1 into minor. To obtain the element of this minor, delete the element of second row and second column. Let us see what we'll get. A11, A13 and A31, A33. Lastly, plus A13, keep it as it is. Here power of minus 1 is odd number, so its value is minus 1. And minor is nothing but determinant. To obtain the element of determinant, delete second row and third column. Second row, third column. What we'll get? A11, A12, A31, A32. Let us simplify it and check what result we are getting here. A11 into minus 1 will be equal to minus A11. Now simplify this determinant. This product is A12 into A33 minus this product will be A13 into A32. Later on, A12 into 1 will be equal to A12 plus A12. Simplify the determinant. This product will be A11 into A33. A11 into A33 minus A13 into A31. And lastly here, minus 1 into A13 will be equal to minus A13. Simplify the determinant. This product will be equal to A11 into A32 minus A12 into A31. Now simplify this expression, open the bracket, minus A11 into this term, means minus A11 into A12 into A33. Minus into minus will become plus, again A11 into A13 into A32. Just I am multiplying by minus A11 to both the terms in this bracket. Now here also use the same method, multiply by A12. So here we will get A11 plus A11 plus A12 plus A33. Again plus into minus is minus, multiply by this term. So let us see what we'll get here. A12, A13, A31. Now multiply by minus A13 to both the term in this bracket. So here we will get minus A11 into A13 into A32. Minus into minus will become plus, and here this product will be A12, A13, A31. So in this way we have simplified this expression. Now observe that in this expression total 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 terms are there. 3 terms are negative and 3 terms are positive. Let us check whether all the terms will get cancelled or not. So this term A11, A12, A13 minus will get cancelled with this plus term, isn't it? A11 plus A11, A12, A33. Now check that this term A plus A11, A13, A32 will get cancelled with this minus term, and these two terms will get cancelled. After cancelling all the terms, remaining term will be 0, means in this way we have shown that value of this expression will be equals to what? 0. But now you will observe this expression very carefully. Here this A11, A12, A13 are the element of what? First row. And observe the cofactor A21, A22, A23, these are the cofactor of element of second row. Means we are multiplying to the element of first row with the cofactor of corresponding element of any other row. Here other row is what? R2. In such cases, what is the value of such expression will be equal to 0. So using this method, total we are getting 12 expression. So we will discuss on this 12 expression, because these 12 expression can be helpful to you while solving the objective type questions. So now observe what result we have got in this case. So we are taking sum. Is it a sum? Yes, it is a sum. Sum of what? Product. Product. Product of what? Sum of product of element of a row or column with cofactor of corresponding element of any other row or column is always equal to what? Zero. We have proved it. So as it stands, we are using element of which row? First row. A11, A12, A13. Isn't it? Observe it. And we have taken cofactor of what? Cofactor of element of what? Second row. A21, A22, A23. At that time, what result we have got? Zero. Just now we have proved it. So similar type of result we will get. Again, we are using element of what? First row. A11, A12, A13. But now I am using cofactor of any other row. Here we have used cofactor of corresponding element of R2. Now instead of R2, we are using cofactor of corresponding element of R3. So cofactor of R3 means A31, A32, A33, till we will get what? Zero. Means two result we have got for the element of what? First row. When we are using element of first row, but cofactor of second row or third row, at that time value of such expression will be equal to zero. Means for first row, we are getting two result. In the same way, for second row also, we will get two such type of expression. For third row also, we will get such type of two expression. Means for three rows, we are getting six expressions. In the same way, for first column we will get two expression, for second column we will get two expression, for third column also we will get two expression. Means total 12 expressions we will get whose value is equal to what? Zero. So let us try to find out again another expression for first column. If we are using element of first column, A11, A21 and A31, isn't it? These are the element of what? First column. Then take the cofactor of what? Any another column. If you are taking cofactor of third column, so A13, A23 and A33. At that time, this important result says that value of this expression will be equal to what? Zero. Hum agar yahan pe first column ke element use kar rahe, but cofactor of what? Any another column. At that time, value of such expression will be equal to zero. But our second important role result says that here A11, A12, A13 are the element of first row. And we are taking its multiplication with what? Its cofactor. A11 ka cofactor kya hai? Capital A11. A12 ka cofactor kya hai? Capital A12. A13 ka cofactor? Capital A13. At that time, value of such expression will be equal to determinant. But instead of element of same cofactor of same cofactor of same element, if we are using cofactor of corresponding element of other row or other column, at that time value of such expression will be equal to what? Zero. Now let us try to prove the second condition. So note down this expression, this important note, and how many such expression we will get here. Total 12 expression. I have shown two expression for first row, similar type of two expression we will get for second row, two expression for third row, two expression for first column, two expression for second column and two expression for third column. So means total 12 expressions we are getting whose value is equal to what? Zero. Now let us try to solve the second example. In the second example, we have considered this left hand side, and simplifying it, we have to show that its value will be equal to determinant of A. So let us simplify this expression. A11, keep it as it is. A11 means it is cofactor. And what is the formula to find out cofactor? -1 raised to power I plus J. Here I is also 1, J is also 1, into M11 plus A12, keep it as it is. Again, cofactor can be find out applying its formula. -1 raised to power I plus J means here 1 plus 2 into M12. Lastly, A13 into -1 raised to power 1 plus 3, 1 plus 3 into M13. So which is equals to, here power of -1 is even number, so its value is +1. +1 into A11 will be A11. Now minor can be find out using determinant. So to find out element of this determinant, delete first row and first column. First row and first column, what we'll get here? A22, A23, A32 and A33. So here power of -1 is odd number, so its value is -1. -1 into A12 will be equals to -A12. Now minor means what? Determinant. To obtain the element of this determinant, delete first row and second column. What we are getting? A21, A23, A31 and A33. Lastly, here power of minus 1 is even number, so its value is plus 1. Plus 1 into A33, A13 will be A13 and value of minor. Delete first row, third column. Delete first row. First row, third column. Remaining element are A12, A22, A31 and A32. So let us simplify this expression, which is equal to A11, keep it as it is. Here take the product of diagonal element, that is A22 into A33 minus this product will be A23 plus A32. Okay, so then minus A12, keep it as it is, minus A12 as it is. Let us simplify this determinant. First take this product, A21 into A33 minus this product will be A32 into A31. Lastly, plus A13, keep it as it is. Take the product of diagonal element A12 into A32 minus this product will be A22 into A31. So whatever may be the expression, we have got here denoted by equation number first, which is nothing but value of what? Left hand side. Now we are finding the value of right hand side, means what? Determinant. So now let us try to find out determinant of this matrix. So which is equals, right? All the element of this matrix in a determinant, that is A11, A12, A13, A21, A22, A23, A31, A32, A33. Let us simplify this determinant A11, keep it as it is. A11, keep it as it is. We are finding its expansion along first row. So A11, keep it as it is. Delete this row and this column. Find out determinant of these four elements. So A22 into A33 minus A23 into A32. Then here plus is there. Then we are taking minus A12. So delete this column. Take the determinant of this four element. So A21 into A33 minus A23 into A31. Lastly, plus A13, keep it as it is. Delete this column and this row. Find out determinant of these four element. This product is A21 into A32 minus A22 into A31. Denote this result, say, by equation number 2. Now if you will observe these two expressions, this expression, equation number first, and this equation number 2, you can observe that all the terms are exactly same. Observe it, and from equation first and second we can conclude that the value of A11 into A11 plus A12 into A12 plus A13 into A13 will be equal to determinant of A. And this completes the solution of second part also. But now we will discuss the important result which you are getting here. That result we are writing as a note here. So see what important result we have got here. The sum of product of element of row or column with its cofactor, means we are taking sum. Is it a sum? Yes, sum of what? Product. Here product is there. Product of element of row or column with its cofactor. These are the element of what? First row. And this is the sum of what? Product of element of a row with its cofactor. And value of such expression will always be equals to determinant of that matrices. So in a matrix, how many rows are there? 3 rows are there. So this expression we have got for first row. We have taken element of first row. A11, A12, A13 are the element of first row, and capital A11, A12, A13 are nothing but its cofactor. Similar type of result we will get for second row also, for third row also, for first column, for second column, for third column. Means total 6 expressions we will get whose value is equal to what? Determinant. So let us try to find out one expression for column number third. So what are the element of column number third? A13, A23 and A33. So now this is the sum of what? product of element of this column with its cofactor. What is the cofactor of A11 will be capital, sorry, A13 will be capital A13, cofactor of A23 will be capital A23, and cofactor of A33 will be capital A33. And value of such expression will always be equals to what? Determinant. So this expression we have got for third column. In this way, total how many expressions we will get? 6. 3 expression for 3 rows and next 3 expression for 3 columns. So in this way, in this example, we have seen total 18 expressions we are getting. So according to this note, we are getting 6 expression whose value is equal to determinant, and in the last part, means in the first part, we have seen 12 expression whose value is equal to what? 0. So remember this important expression and important note also. Now let us try to solve the last example from this exercise. In this example, one matrix A is given to us and B is also given, and these two matrices satisfies one equation. Observe the equation, x into A is equals to B. So matrix A is given, B is also given, but matrix X is not given. So solving this equation, question is to find out matrix X, find a matrix X. So let us try to find out value of matrix X, A and B. We have already written the given condition, matrix A and matrix B is given to us. And here, what is the given equation? X into A is equals to B. So substitute the value of matrix A and matrix B here. Now here our aim is to find out the element of which matrix? X. And to find out the element of this matrix X, if we are able to convert this matrix into identity, so identity into X will become X, means on this side we will get X if we are able to convert this matrix into identity. And whatever may be the new matrices on this side we are getting will be required value of X. Now to convert this matrix into identity, we have to check that we have to apply row transformation or column transformation. If you will observe our required value, what is our required value? Matrix X, which is nothing but prefactor. And in case of prefactor, we know that prefactor remains constant in case of what? Column transformation. Means to convert this matrix into identity, we have to apply what? Column transformation. So using column transformation, now we are trying to convert this matrix into identity matrix. And what is the first step in case of column transformation? First step is to convert the element of first row into 1, 0, 0. So here already 1 is there, 0 is also there. Just simply try to convert this element into what? 0. And to convert this element into 0, we can observe that this is the element of what? C3. And what is the element of C3? 1. From 1 we have to subtract 1, and 1 is already here in C1, so we are taking subtraction of C3 and C1. So let us take this subtraction and see what result we are getting here. Keep X as it is, keep element of first column also as it is, second column also as it is. Perform this operation on the element of C3. 1 minus 1 is 0, then 3 minus 0 will be 3, 1 minus 1 is 0, and on this side also perform the same operation on the element of C3. 2, 1, 4, keep it as it is. So C3 minus C1 means 3 minus 1 is 2, 5 minus 1 is 4, and 7 minus 2 will be equal to 5. Now, here easily we can observe that if we are dividing to the element of C2 by 2 and C3 by 3, what we will get here? 0, 1, 1, and here 0, 1, 0. But 0, 1, 0 are the element of what? Second column in identity matrix. So that's why if I am dividing here by 2 and here by 3, and if we are interchanging the columns, we will get the element similar to the element of what? Identity matrix. So let us see what result we are getting after performing this operation. Our operation is on C2 and C3, so keep element of C1 as it is. Now observe it very carefully. We are dividing to C3 by 3 and we are shifting this element into C2. So divided by 3, what we'll get? 0, 1, 0, and write down this element in C2. And we are dividing to C2 by 2 and write down this element in which column? Third column. So if we are dividing by 2, here we will get 0, 1, 1. So on this side, keep element of C1 as it is, 1, 1, 2 as it is. Now I am dividing to C3 by 3 and write down these element into C2. So what we'll get here? 2 by 3, then 4 by 3, and then what? 5 by 3. And we are dividing to the element of C2 by 2, divide by 2. So here we'll get 1, here we will get 1 by 2 if we are dividing by 2, and here we are getting 2 if we are dividing by 2. So and these element we are writing in what? C3, because we are interchanging the element of second column and third column after performing these operations. So now here we can observe that if we are able to convert this element into 0, so our second step will also get complete. What is our second step? To get 1001. So let us try to get 0 here. To get 0 here, our operation is on C3, C3 minus C2. So after performing this operation, this element will become what? 0. So let us perform this operation on the element of C3. So keep element of C1 as it is, even the element of C2 also as it is. Perform this operation very carefully on the element of C3. 0 minus 0 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0, and 1 minus 0 will be equal to 1. Same operation we are performing on this side. 1, 1, 2, keep it as it is. Now we are taking difference of C3 and C2. So 1 minus 2 by 3 will be equal to 1 by 3. Here better way, first write down the element of C2, because there is no operation on C2. Now 1 by 2 minus 4 by 3. So let us see what we'll get. 1 by 2 minus 4 by 3 will be equal to 3 minus 8. Take the cross multiplication. 3 minus 8 is minus 5, minus 5 by 6. So here we'll get minus 5 by 6. And lastly, let us perform this operation on this element. C3 means what? 2 here. And from 2, we are subtracting 5 by 3. Minus 5 by 3. So 3 into 2 is 6. 6 minus 5 is 1. So here we'll get 1 by 3. So now, after performing this operation, now last part is to convert this element into 0. To convert this matrix into identity means our operation is on C1. C1 minus C3 will convert this element into 0, and means this matrix into identity matrix. So here operation is on C1, C1 minus C3. Let us perform this operation. Keep this matrix X as it is. So here C1 minus C3 means 1 minus 0 will be equal to 1, 0 minus 0 is 0, 1 minus 1 is 0. Keep element of C2 and C3 as it is, as there is no operation on C2 and C3. Perform the same operation on this side also very carefully. C1 minus C3, 1 minus 1 by 3 is 2 by 3, 1 minus minus means plus 5 by 3 will be equals to 6 plus 5 will be 11, 11 by 6, and here 2 minus 1 by 3 will be equal to 5 by 3. So 6 minus 1 will be equal to 5. So keep remaining element as it is, 2 by 3, 4 by 3, 5 by 3. On this, an element of third column are 1 by 3 minus 5 by 6 and 1 by 3. So on this side, identity into matrix X will be matrix X. And if you'll observe the element in the denominator are what? 3 and what? 6. So LCM of 3 and 6 will be equals to 6. So we are dividing here by 6, and since I am dividing by 6, that's why I am multiplying by 6. So let us multiply by 6 here. We will get 12. 12 upon 3 will be equal to 4. Multiply by 6, we will get 12. 12 upon 3 will be equal to 4. Multiply by 6, 6 upon 3 will be equal to 2. Multiply by 6, 6 will get cancelled, we will get 11. Multiply by 6, so it will get 24. 24 upon 3 will be 8. 6 will get cancelled, here will get minus 5. If I am multiplying here by 6, 30, 30 upon 3 is 10. Multiply by 6, here also will get 30. 30 upon 3 will be equal to 10. And here if we are multiplying by 6, 6 upon 3 will be equal to 2. In this way, we have got the element of matrix X. In this way, we have completed this exercise. In the next video, we are starting last article from this chapter, that is application of matrices, in which we will study two methods. One is inversion and one is reduction method to solve the linear equations. In this way, we have completed this exercise. in the next video, we are starting next article from this chapter, that is application of matrices, in which we will solve the linear equation applying two method, reduction and inversion. So if you think that these videos are very helpful to you, so please like the videos and please share these videos with your friends also.